نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصدها ما كانت تعبد من دون الله انها كانت من قوم كافرين قيل لها ادخلي الصرح فلما رأته حسبته لجة وكشفت عن ساقيها قال انه صرح ممرد من قوارير قالت رب اني ظلمت نفسي واسلمت مع سليمان لله رب العالمين صدق الله العظيم. These two ayat remained from the third section of Surah An-Naml, the end of the story of Hazrat Sulaiman alayhis salam and the Queen of Sheba. When she said that this throne is just like mine, it's as if it's the same. And then also said, وَأُوتِينَ الْعِلْمَ مِنْ قَبْلِهَا وَكُنَّا مُسْلِمِينَ. We have had the knowledge already that you are not a simple king, not a common man. You are something else. And we had ourselves submitted and surrendered, maybe to Allah also, and maybe to you. وَصَدَّهَا مَا كَانَ تَعْبُدُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Then Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salam stopped her from worshipping which she used to worship beside Allah. إِنَّهَا كَانَتْ مِنْ قَوْمٍ كَافِرِينَ. Verily she was from among the people who were disbelieving. قِلَ لَهَا ادْخُلِي الصَّرْحَ. And then it was said to her, enter the palace. فَلَمَّا رَآتْهُ حَسِبَتْهُ لُجَّةً. When she saw it, she thought that it was water. وَكَشَفَتْ عَنْ سَاقَيْهَا. So she uncovered her legs. قَالَ إِنَّهُ صَرْحٌ مُمَرَّدٌ مِنْ قَوَارِيرٍ. Sulaiman said, it's not water. This is a palace which has been lined by glasses, crystal or glass. قَالَتْ رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي. Then she said, oh my Lord, I have been doing wrong to myself. وَأَسْلَمْتُ مَعَ سُلَيْمَانَ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And now I surrender with Sulaiman to Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Now this was the part of the surah relating some story of a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now again we revert to the Ambaur Rusul. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ سَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. And we had sent to the nation of Samud their brother Salih alayhi salam. أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهَ فَإِذَاهُمْ فَرِيقَانِ يَقْتَصِمُونَ. That you should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So lo, they became two parties quarreling with each other. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تَسْتَعْجِرُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلِ الْحَسَنَةِ. And the disbelievers must have said, okay, Saleh, bring the chastisement that you have been threatening us with. But he said, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ, oh my people, لِمَ تَسْتَعْجِرُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلِ الْحَسَنَةِ. Why do you want to hasten the evil thing before good? لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Why don't you ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Maybe that he shows mercy upon you. قَالُوا طَيَّرْنَا بِكَ وَبِمَنْ مَعَكَ. They said, we augur ill omen of you and those who are with you. قَالَ تَعَيْرُكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهِ. He said, your ill omen is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ تُفْتَنُونَ. But you are the people who are being tested and tried. وَكَانَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ تِسْعَةُ رَحْتٍ. And there were in the city a group of 9 persons, يُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, who were used to making mischief in the land. وَلَا يُسْلِحُونَ. And they didn't want to have matters in a correct way. قَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ. They said to each other, let us swear by Allah among ourselves. لَنُبَيَّتَنَّهُ وَأَهْلَهُ. We should attack him, Saleh, and his family. Kill them. ثُمَّ لَنَقُولَنَّ لِوَلِيِّهِ. Then we shall say to their heir, مَا شَهِدْنَا مَهْلِكَ أَهْلِهِ. We never witnessed the destruction of his family. وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ. and we are true. Whatever we are saying is true. Now, this was the same plot that were being hatched at Makkah for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People, the Quraysh, the chiefs, they gathered together. They said, if someone goes and kills Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you know Banu Hashim will demand revenge from that family. So you should do that. From every big family of the Quraysh, one young man should be taken. And all of them should be entrusted with this mission of killing Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, murdering him. So they should gather around the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and then attack jointly, so that the blame will not come to any one family, but it will be shared by all the families. And then, you know, Banu Hashim will not be able to ask for revenge from all the families of Quraysh. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the Prophet. He got out, and they couldn't see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam going out. And the Prophet asked Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu to lie in his bed, and he went out, and they couldn't see him. Well, this is a miracle by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he possessed their sights at that time, that the Prophet went out of his house, but they couldn't see him. So the same, you know, plot was being hatched by those 9 persons. وَمَكَرُوا مَكْرًا وَمَكَرْنَا مَكْرًا. And they devised a plan, and we also devised a plan. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And they have no thought of it. That is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to send the chastisement and that, you know, punishment to annihilate them. فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ مَكْرِهِمْ. Now see, what was the end of their plotting? أَنَّا دَمَّرْنَاهُمْ. We destroyed them all. وَقَوْمَهُمْ. And also their nation, أَجْمَعِينَ, all together. فَتِلْكَ بُيُوتُهُمْ خَاوِيَةٌ. Now there are their houses which are fallen down, bima zalamu, due to their evil acts. These houses are not to be found today. They had two types of dwellings, the Samud. One type of houses they carved in the mountains. So they are still present today. But in the plains, they used to make houses of mud, etc. But they are not, though no remains of those houses are to be seen now. But those houses that they carved in the mountains, they are there. A few years back, I visited the place, I saw it. فَتِلْكَ بُيُوتُهُمْ خَاوِيَةٌ بِمَا ظَلَمُوا إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً لِقَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ. Verily, this is a sign for those people who have knowledge. وَأَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. And we saved those who had believed and they were God-fearing. وَلُوتًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ. In the same way, we sent Lut, alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said to his nation, أَتَاتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ. Are you committing indecency? What an evil indecency. وَأَنْتُمْ تُبْصِرُونَ. And you do it and watch it. Watch each other doing it. أَيْنَّكُمْ لَتَعْتُونَ الرِّجَالَ شَهْوَةً. Do you approach men for your sexual desire? مِنْ دُونِ النِّسَى. Leaving alone the women. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ تَجْهَلُونَ. They are, but you are surely senseless people. فَمَا كَانَ جَوَابَ قَوْمِهِ. But there was no answer of his nation. إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا. Except that they said, أَخْرِجُوا عَلَى لُوتٍ مِنْ قَرْيَتِكُمْ. Expel this family of Lut from your city. Innahum unasun yatatahharun. They claim to be pure and pious people. It was a taunting mood. They are very pious people. Well, we are sinning people. So they shouldn't be allowed to live with us. They should be turned away. They should be expelled. Fanjaynahu wa ahlahu illa imra'atah. So we delivered him and his family except his wife. قَدَّرْنَاهَا مِنَ الْغَابِرِينَ. We had already ordained that she will be among those who were left behind. وَأَمْتَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَطَرًا. And then we sent a rain over them. فَسَاءَ مَطَرُ الْمُنْزَرِينَ. So how evil was the rain which was sent to those people who had been warned. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَىٰ. Say, all praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ, and peace be upon his bondsmen and servants whom he has chosen. This is istafa. We read it in Surah Al-Hajj. Allahu yastafi min al-malaikati rusulam wa min al-nas. Allah chooses his messengers from among the angels as well as from among human beings. Jibreel, the angel, he is number one chosen for this messengership, and number two, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and so on. Before Muhammad, so many other messengers were chosen. Qul alhamdulillah, say, all praise be to Allah. Wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina istafa, and peace be upon those servants whom he had chosen for this mission of messengerhood. Allahu khairun amma yushrikun. Is Allah better or what they associate with him? Now from here you know, this is a tazkir bi ala illah, the third section of this surah. I told you three types of subjects in Makki surahs: tazkir bi ala illah, tazkir bi ayyamillah, ambaur rusul, and then the stories of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have had two, now the third. أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَأَنزَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. Who is the one who created the heavens and the earth and sent down for you from the heaven water? فَأَنبَتْنَا بِهِ حَدَائِقَ ذَاتَ بَهْجَةٍ. And then he grew with that water orchards which are of delight. مَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَن تُنبِتُوا شَجَرَهَا. It was not possible for you to grow their trees. Now this is a question with piercing eyes. What do you say? Is there any other God with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has done this? Balhum qawmun ya'dilun. Nay, but they are making others equal to Allah. Amman ja'ala al-ardha qarara. Who is he who has made the earth a fixed abode, a place to stay? وَجَعَلَ خِلَالَهَا أَنْهَارًا, and placed rivers in its midst. وَجَعَلَ لَهَا رَوَاسِيَا, and then he fixed upon it mountains. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ حَاجِزًا, and he has put between two currents of the sea a barrier. أَإِلَهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is there any other ilah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Any other God with him? بَلْ أَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Nay, but most of them know not. أَمَّنْ يُجِيمُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. Or who is he who listens to the distressed one when he calls upon him and accepts his prayers? وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ, and then he relieves him of his suffering and affliction. وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ, and he makes you the successors in this earth. أَإِلَهُمْ أَلَّهُ. Is there any other God with Allah? قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. It's very little that you are admonished. أَمَّنْ يَهْدِيكُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Or who is he who guides you through the darknesses of the land and the sea? وَمَنْ يُرْسَلُ الرِّيَاحَ بُشْرًا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَحْمَتِهِ. And who is he who sends cool wind before his mercy, that is rain? أَإِلَهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is this thing done by some other God except Allah? تَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. He is exalted, very high from what they are associating with him. أَمَّنْ يَبْدَعُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدَهُ. Or who is he who creates, originates the creation for the first time? ثُمَّ يُعِيدَهُ, and then repeats it. وَمَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ, and who feeds you, provides you from this heaven and the earth? أَإِلَهُ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is another ilah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bring forth your argument if you are true. قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Say, none in the heavens and the earth knows the things which are unseen except Allah. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ أَيَّانَ يُبْعَثُونَ And they don't know when they will be resurrected. People in the grave, they don't know when they will be resurrected. بَلِ اِدَّارَكَ عِلْمُهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ But their knowledge has failed to comprehend the hereafter. They are not ready to believe in the hereafter. بَلْهُمْ فِي شَكِّمْ مِنْهَا They are in doubt about it, concerning it. بَلْهُمْ مِنْهَا عَمُونَ Rather, we should say, they are blind to it. They are blind and they can't see the Akhirah. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَإِذَا كُنَّا تُرَابًا وَآبَاؤُنَا أَيْنَّا لَمُخْرَجُونَ And those who disbelieve, they say, when we should become dust, not only we, but also our forefathers, أَيْنَّا لَمُخْرَجُونَ Then, will we be taken out again? لَقَدْ وَعِدْنَا هَذَا نَحْنُ وَآبَاؤُنَا مِنْ قَبْلُ This was promised to us also before and to our forefathers. In hadha illa asatirul awwaleen. But I am not going to believe. And these are the fables and stories of the ancients. Qul siru fil ard. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You travel in the world, in the land. Fanzuru kaifa kana aqibatul mujrimeen. And then see for yourself. What was the end of the culprits and the guilty? What happened to the people of Aad? What happened to Samud? What happened to the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah? What happened to Madian? What happened to Fir'aun? Go and see. وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ But you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't be grieved over them. Well, to them is going to come the chastisement, but you don't grieve over them. وَلَا تَكُنْ فِي زَيْقِ بِمَّا يُمْكُرُونَ And don't also be perturbed due to their planning, whatever planning they are making for you, to kill you or to expel you out from Makkah. But don't be grieved. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will, whatever He wishes, He will decide. وَيَقُولُنَا مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ And they say, when will be this promise come to pass? إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ If you are true. قُلْ عَسَىٰ يَكُونَ رَدِفَ لَكُمْ بَعْضُ الَّذِي تَسْتَعَجَلُونَ Say, it may be that what you seek to hasten on is just behind you. Maybe that chastisement is very close, has come very near to you, just behind you. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ Verily your Lord has bounty over the people. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ But most of them are ungrateful. If he is not showing a clear visible, palpable sign, it's his mercy. But they don't know it. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَيَعْلَمُ مَا تُقِنُّ صُدُورُهُمْ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ And verily your Lord knows very well what their chests are hiding in them, concealing, and what they reveal and say out. وَمَا مِنْ غَائِبَةٍ فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ And there's nothing hidden in the heaven or in the earth. But it is recorded in a book which is very clear. Kitabim Mubin. Inna hadha al-Qur'ana yaqussu ala bani Israel aksar al-lazihum fihi yakhtalifun. This Qur'an narrates to the children of Israel most of these things about which they have been differing. Wa innahu lahudam wa rahmatun lil-mu'mineen. And this is the guidance and the mercy for those who believe in him. Inna rabbaka yaqzi bainahum bihukmihi. And verily your Lord will judge between them with his authority. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْعَلِيمُ And he is all-powerful. He has all the authority. And all-knowing. He knows everything. فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, put your trust wholly and solely in Allah. إِنَّكَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ الْمُبِينَ Surely you are upon the clear truth. But you have is the truth. إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَى But you cannot make the dead to hear. وَلَا تُسْمِعُ سُمَّ الدُّعَى Nor you can make the deaf to hear. إِذَا وَاللَّهُ مُدْبُرِينَ Especially when they turn their backs and go away. If somebody is deaf, but he is facing you, then you can convey something through gestures. But when he has turned his back also, going away, now he's deaf also. Now you can't convey to him anything. innaka la tusmi'ul mauta, you cannot make the dead listen, nor you can make the deaf listen, especially when they turn their backs and go. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِهَادِ الْعُمْيِ عَنْ ضَلَالَتِهِمْ, nor you can guide the blind from their error. إِنْ تُسْمِعُوا إِلَّا مَنْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا فَهُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. You can make hear only those people who believe in our revelations and who are Muslims, who surrender to the will of Allah. وَإِذَا وَقَى الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ, and when the word becomes operative upon them, أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ, we shall take out, bring forth from the land, from the earth, a beast for them, تُكَلِّمُهُمْ, which will speak to them. إِنَّ النَّاسَ كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا لَا يُوقِنُونَ, but these people were not believing in our ayat, in our revelations. Now this is one of the signs of the last hour. Ashratu sa'a alamatul qiyamah, what events will take place before the end of this world. So one of these things, you know, three very major signs which will herald the coming of the last hour. Number one, rising of the sun from the west. Number two, an animal, a beast will come out from the earth. And they say it will come out from the hillock of Safa or Marwa in Makkah. Yeah. And it will speak to the people. And third is Dajjal. So these three signs are from among the greatest signs which will appear before the end of this world. وَيَوْمَ نَحْشُرُهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ فَوْجًا يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ فَوْجًا مِمَّنْ يَكَذِّبُ بِآيَاتِنَا فَهُمْ يُوزَعُونَ. And just visualize the day when we shall gather together all of the people, a host of those who belied our revelations, and they will be set in bands and squads. These were the disbelievers. They were the disbelievers, you know, of the highest degree. They were of the second degree. So there will be gradations also. Not all believers are equal, and not all disbelievers are equal. نہ ہر زن زنستو نہ ہر مرد مرد خدا پنج انگوش یکسانہ کرد. Neither every man is a man, nor a woman is a woman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not made these five fingers equal. So disbelievers will have also different shades. So they will be divided into squads and bands. حَتَّى اِذَا جَاؤُ, until when they will come before their Lord, قَالَ أَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِآيَاتِ, Allah will say, did you belie my revelations? وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا عِلْمًا, and the reason was that you could not comprehend our ayat. You could not understand. أَمْ مَاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, or what were you doing? There could be two reasons. Either they couldn't comprehend, they couldn't understand, and that is why they were denying it. Or they had understood. They had come to recognize that these are the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But still, they were adamant. Why should us believe in it? Then Muhammad will become superior, we shall become inferior. Just as was the case of the ulama, the knowledgeable people of Bani Israel in Medina. Quran says at more than one places, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ, they recognize Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Quran just as they recognize their sons. But they were not ready to accept him, not ready to believe in him. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاؤُوا قَالَ أَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِآيَاتِي وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا عِلْمًا, you couldn't comprehend those, my revelations, and that is why you refused to accept them. أَمَّاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, or what were you doing? وَوَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمَا ظَلَمُوا فَهُمْ لَا يَنْتَقُونَ, and then the command of chastisement will come to pass against them because they did evil, so they will not speak. أَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا جَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِيَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ, don't they see that we have made the night for them so that they should have take rest in it, have a repose. وَالنَّهَارَ مُبْصِرَةً, and we have made the day to see, Inna fi zalika la ayatin li qaumin yu'minun. Verily, in this are the signs for those people who believe. وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ, and the day when the trumpet would be blown. فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. So everyone would be terrified, whether he is in the heavens or in the earth. إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ, except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. We can't say who they will be. Maybe the Hamaratul Arsh, the angels who are holding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe. But you know, because man fis samawati wa min fard, it means include the angels generally are included. When that trumpet of the hour will be blown, everybody would be terrified. Illa man sha Allah, except those whom Allah wishes. Maybe Muhammadur Rasulullah might be the exempt. Maybe Jesus, maybe Moses also, maybe. We can't say. But you know, the general rule is that all will feel terrified. وَكُلُّ نَتَاهُ دَآخِرِينَ, and all will come to him and approach him with the humbleness, humility. وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً, and you shall see the mountains. You think they are very solid, firmly fixed. وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ, but they will move just as the clouds move. سُنَعَ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتْقَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ, well, this is the creation of Allah, handiwork of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has perfected everything. إِنَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَفْعَلُونَ, he knows what you are doing. مَنْ جَعَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِنْهَا, whosoever comes on the day of judgment will hasana, with good deeds. فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهَا, for him will be the reward much better than his deeds that he had brought. وَهُمْ مِّنْ فَضَعِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ آمِنُونَ, and they will be saved and secure from the terror of that day. وَمَنْ جَعَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ, and whosoever will come with bad deeds. فَكُبَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ فِي النَّارِ, so they will be thrown on their faces in the fire of hell. هَلْ تُجْزَوْنَ إِلَّا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, you are only being rewarded and punished for what you did. إِنَّمَا أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ رَبَّ هَذِهِ الْبَيْتِ الْبَلْدَةِ الَّتِي كَرَّمَهَا. Now these are the last ayat of the surah. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have been commanded to worship the Lord of this city, Makkah. Makkah, you know, because Baytullah was there. So this city, the Lord of Makkah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allazi harramaha, who has sanctified this city, Baladul Ameen, Baladul Haram. Walahu kullu shayin, and to him belongs everything, everything, everything. Wa umirtu an akuna min al-Muslimin, and I have been commanded to be one of the Muslims, to be included in those who surrendered themselves and their wills to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنْ أَتْلُوَ الْقُرْآنَ, and I have been commanded that I should continue reciting Quran. Reciting for myself also, to get the strength. يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُزَّمِّلُ قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا نِصْفَهُ وَانْقُصْ مِنْهُ قَلِيلًا وَزِدْ عَلَيْهِ وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. This was for the spiritual elevation of the Prophet himself. But then during the daytime, he was reciting it to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the people. Reading out Quran for them, reciting Quran for them. So atlu al Quran means both. One atlu al Quran. For man ihtada fa innama yahtadi li nafsihi. So whosoever gets to the right path, well, he is guided for his own benefit. Wa man dhalla, and whosoever goes astray, fa qul innama ana min al munzirin. Tell him that I am only a warner. I can't force you to come to the right way. It has to be your own choice. I am only Nazir and Bashir. I am only the Muballigh. وَمَا عَلَىٰ رَسُولِنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ. The responsibility of our messenger is only to convey to you clearly. وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, and say in the end, all praise belongs to Allah. سَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ فَتَعْرِفُونَهَا, Very soon he will show you some of his signs and you will be able to recognize them. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِرٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And your Lord is not unaware of what you do. Now we come to Surah Al-Qasas. This surah contains a quite detailed narrative about the life story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. We have read it in detail in Surah Al-Taha. 5 sections of that surah, they were, you know, occupied by the story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. Here again, Surah Al-Qasas, it is giving some additional details. Some of the things are repeated and there are other things which are additional. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Taasimim. Tilka ayatul kitabil mubin. These are the ayat of the clear book, manifest book. Natlu alayka min nabai Musa wa Fir'aun. We are going to recite to you the story of Musa and Fir'aun. Bilhaq, with truth. Everything that we say is 100% correct. Liqawmi yuminun. For those people who believe. Inna Fir'aun ala fil ard. Verily, Fir'aun had exalted himself in the land. Waja'ala ahlaha shi'an. And he had made the people, divided them into sects and groups. Yastad'ifu ta'ifatan minhum. He was slaughtering their sons. Yastad'ifu. Abasing and oppressing some of them. Yuzabbihu abna'ahum. Slaughtering their sons. Yastahyi nisa'ahum. And keeping alive their women. Innahu kana min al-mufsideen. No doubt, surely, he was of the corruptors and the mischief mongers. You know, this was the command of Fir'aun at that time, that every male child born to any Israeli woman must be killed. Now, what was the reason? There's no mention in Quran. There's no mention in Torah even. But there are some stories in Talmud. And you know, our Mufassirin have also borrowed them from Talmud. That is, that the Fir'aun, he saw a dream that a child is born to an Israeli woman who will overthrow his kingdom. So, on the basis of this vision and dream, he gave the order. Whosoever Israeli woman bears a male child, kill him. But the second reason can be, as I told you, it was a nationalist strife. Because Bani Israel were very prosperous. When they had entered Egypt, the kings at that time, the king was not a pharaoh. He was not a son of the soil. He was not an Egyptian. They were from the Amalekah. And actually they were Arabs. So they were, so to say, foreign occupiers of Egypt. And they needed some section of the population to support them against any local nationalistic uprising. So he gave the best land to Bani Israel. Joshua, near the delta of Nile, the best lands he gave to the Israelites. You go settle here. And they were very prosperous. And they multiplied in great number. But after some years, then there was a revolt, local revolt, an uprising. The local peoples drove out the Amalekah. They had to run away. And now this was a nationalist resurgence in Egypt. Again, now the dynasty of Pharaoh started. And now these people, who were pampered during the former king, and in their regimes, now they were persecuted. They were thought to be the agents of those enemies of Egypt. But because they were increasing in number, they were fearing that they might sometime challenge us in our land. And we have read, you know, that Fir'aun said, these are two magicians who want to drive you out of your land. So he was saying it, that actually it's a political, you know, scheme. And they want to deprive us of this land of ours, Egypt, and to occupy it. And there are a great number of Israelis are there. And now he has come equipped with these, you know magic things. So that is the fear. So maybe any one of these two things can be true. Inna Fir'auna ala fil ard. Verily, Fir'aun exalted himself in the earth, in the land. Waja'ala ahlaha shi'an, and made its people, divided them into sects and groups. Yastad'ifu ta'ifatan minhum. One of the groups he was oppressing. Yuzabbihu abna'ahum, to the extent that he was killing their sons, male sons, by yastahyi nisa'ahum, and keeping alive their female daughters, their female progeny. Innahu kana min al-mufsidin, definitely he was from among the corruptors and the mischief mongers. Wa nuridu an namunna 'ala allazina istud'afu. And we had decided that we shall bestow our favor on those who were oppressed in the land. So now we wanted to come to help of Bani Israel, to relieve them, to get the release for them. Nuridu an namunna 'ala allazina istud'afu fil ard. وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَيْمَّةً, and we make them the leaders. وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِسِينَ, and make them the inheritors of the rule in this land. وَنُمَكِّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and yet, and that we should establish them in the land. وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا, and show to Fir'aun and Haman and their hosts and their armies, minhum ma kanu yahzarun, what they were dreading or fearing. I have given you the detail of this dreading and fearing of what? Either the domination of Bani Israel in Egypt due to their numbers, and now Moses by their side, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam also with them. Or as the stories are and the traditions are, that he had seen a dream that a child is born Bani Israel who overthrows his kingdom. But we decided to show him that this is going to happen. You might have killed thousands of the sons of Bani Israel, but still, you know, one was saved. Who had to overthrow your kingdom, he was saved. Because Allah Ta'ala does what he wants. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ. Now this we have read in Surah Taha. And we sent the revelation to the mother of Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam, an arzi'ihi, go on suckling him. Faida khifti alayhi, then when you have a fear that he might be found out, when the people, you know, searching the homes are coming, falqihi fil yam, then you cast him into the Nile, into the river. Wala takhafi, don't fear. Wala tahzani, and don't grieve. Inna radduhu ilayki. We promise we shall return him to you. وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, and we will make him from among our messengers. Now this is the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming to a woman. But she was not prophet. Allah can send wahi and ilham to other people also. Even we have read, أَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ, Allah sent the wahi to the honey bee. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in some animals as instincts, it's also a wahi to them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this message to the mother of Musa. فَالْتَقَطَهُ عَالُ فِرْعَوْنَ. So the people of Fir'aun picked him up from the river. لَيَكُونَ لَهُمْ عَدُوًّا وَحَزَنًا, so that he might become for them enemy and the reason of grief. Inna Fir'auna wa Hamana wa junudahuma. Verily, not only Fir'aun and Haman, but all of their armies, kanu khatiin, they committed a mistake. They were evildoers, and now they committed this mistake because they didn't kill Musa. Why didn't they kill? وَقَالَتْ اِمْرَاتُ فِرْعَونَ. Now the wife of Fir'aun came in the way. They wanted, they had recognized that this is an Israeli child. But now wife, who was beloved of Fir'aun, she came in the between. قَالَتْ اِمْرَاتُ فِرْعَونَ قُرَةٌ لِي وَلَّي قُرَةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَّكْ. Oh Fir'aun, this child will be a coolness to my eyes and yours. And we have read already, أَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي. Allah has put on Musa alayhi salam, you know, a reflection of his own love. Whosoever saw him started loving him. So both these things. Firstly, the appearance of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, a very beautiful, very lovely child. Secondly, this wife. Torah says she was daughter of Fir'aun, but Quran says no, she was the wife of Fir'aun. And she has been mentioned in Surah Al-Tahrim as one of the most exemplary women, because although she was living in the house of Fir'aun, an enemy of Allah, but she was herself a saint, a waliullah, waliya lillah. And she was from among the Israelites. She was an Israeli woman. Just as you know, kings, they marry. Some woman might have been very beautiful, and he liked her and brought her in the palace. قَالَتْ اِمْرَاتُ فِرْعَوْنَ قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكْ لَا تَقْتُلُوهُ. Don't kill him. عَسَىٰ يَنْفَعَنَا. Maybe he proves to be beneficial for us. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا. Or we shall adopt him as a son, because they had no son till that time. After some time, there was a son, and that was the Fir'aun when Hazrat Musa comes back from Madian. Now he was the Fir'aun. But till this time, the father was in charge. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And they didn't know what they are doing. They were actually their enemy, Musa, who will overthrow their kingdom. But they are decided not to kill him. وَأَصْبَحَ فُعَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا. And in the meantime, the heart of Musa's mother became empty. You know, her courage gave way. The love and affection for the son, she couldn't bear anymore. In قَادَتْ لَتُمْدِي بِهِ. She was very close to disclose everything. She was close that she would have exploded, that this was my son and I have done this, and I have, you know, cast him into the Nile, and go and see, and please take it back. لَوْلَا أَنْ رَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا. Had we not strengthened her heart, we strengthened her heart so that she could bear. لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So that she becomes from among the believers. وَقَالَتْ لِأُخْتِهِ. And she said to his sister of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, قُسِّيهِ. Go and follow, you know, that basket or whatever you may call, which was carrying Musa alayhi salam, the Nile. Go along with the coast of the river. See. قُسِّيهِ. Go along with it. فَبَصُرَتْ بِهِ عَنْ جُنُبٍ. So she kept an eye on that basket or whatever it was, a box. عَنْ جُنُبٍ. From afar, a distance. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. They didn't know that, you know, someone is watching this child. وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And we had prevented him beforehand to drink the milk of all the foster mothers. So many women were called, said that she should suckle him. But he didn't accept. He won't touch the mammary gland of the mother, of that foster mother. So all were tried. But Moses alayhi salatu wasalam accepted none. So now there was an emergency. How will he live? He is not ready to accept the milk of any woman. So then she said, the sister, وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَقَالَتْ هل ادلكم على اهل بيت يكفلونه. Should I guide you to a family who will be able to take care of him? وهم له ناصحون. And they are for him, they will look after him and they are sincere to him. فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ. In this way, we returned him to his mother. كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا. So that her eyes should remain cool. وَلَا تَحْزَن. And she should not be grieved. وَلَتَعْلَمَ. And so that she should come to know and believe. أَنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. That the promise of Allah is true. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of them know not. They don't have the true knowledge. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم.